Hi, all. Thanks so much for watching. Speaking of making healthcare work for you, different perspectives and empowering solutions. I'm Stephanie Fields, joined by my co-host, Dr. Apoorv Gupta, and we are talking about our interview with Pramod John, who is the CEO of Vivio Health. And I say this, I think, on every single one of our calls. We just must always find amazing people, but it was one of my favorite interviews and just so incredibly genuine. It was just a genuine conversation and really didn't talk a whole lot about Vivio Health, but what they do is they do drug research on data-driven drug research, you know, outside of the FDA to really get to the bottom of what's working and, you know, how people can use it. And they want to work in tandem with providers and, you know, be a tool for them, not be a threat to them, which they said they've encountered just a little bit. So they're trying to really let people know, providers know, that they're out there to work with them and help them practice at their highest levels, where they don't have to spend their time looking at clinical research and, you know, drug trials and things like that. And so that's what they do. They do really important work, but really Pramod spent so much time talking to us about why this is an issue and why he cares about it. And gosh, the one thing he said, you know, that stuck out to me was at the very end, and I might not even have been on the recording, was when he said, why can't we do it differently? You know, we don't have to do it this way. And does the FDA have a law that says we have to just follow their recommendations? And he talked to us about, you know, drugs that really just don't have any benefit, but are so often prescribed and overwhelmed with the physicians trying to keep up with all of these drugs. And during our pre-call, he did not mention this in the interview, but it made us, both of us, laugh. He was talking about how they always say that the reasons that drug costs are so expensive are because Americans are overweight and Americans are this and that. And he said, do we weigh them when they come in and do we charge more based on the pounds? And I just thought that was hilarious because it, you know, nobody does. Like, why do we say that it's just because Americans are obese? Oh, that's why the cost is $4 trillion. That makes no sense. And he just, oh gosh, talked so many great things about the drug industry and his hope for it and how Vivio is going to change it. Apoorv, what stood out to you?
Well, I'm reflecting on what you said, Stephanie. Talk about different perspectives and empowering solutions. Here's a guy who had nothing to do with healthcare. He made it well and did great in Silicon Valley in the IT space. And then as he started to think about towards the end of his career, as he's saying, what are the big challenges and why aren't we dealing with those? He realized that healthcare is really where the big challenge is. About 10 years ago, when he started thinking about this, the healthcare industry was a $3 trillion industry. And now 10 years later, with all the efforts we've been trying to put into it, we think we're trying to do our best to slow it down. And lo and behold, it's a $4 trillion industry. So it's a massive juggernaut. And I think folks like Pramod getting involved and getting with their understanding of how the industry works, with their understanding of how data works, and being sensitive to what the challenges are on the physician side. That's the one thing I think that came across really clearly. They can't just lay this at the feet of physicians. I think they're trying to understand that the physicians are ultimately caught up in this process, that they're overwhelmed. They don't have the tools. They don't have the time. They don't really have the resources. And so they've got to find a different way to partner with them if they're going to try to change this equation. So I think it was a very empowering idea that they're working on. At the same time, it's still early. There's no clear solutions that he could point to that are yet out there that show the way of how the future is going to look like when technology and data come together in the right interface with humans. So I think a lot of this is still more promise and optimism, and we haven't yet quite delivered on what the real solution needs to look like. But I really appreciated Pramod's approach, his perspective. I think he's definitely thinking about a very complex situation in a really meaningful and intense way. And I think he's trying to do it for the right reasons. As you said, he wants to leave the world better off for his kids and for all our kids. So I think more power to him and Vivio. And I'm really looking forward to hearing much more about how his story develops.
Absolutely. And when you were talking about it again, I was listening during the interview and I couldn't pinpoint it, but he kept saying, you know, let's focus, let the computers do what they're good at. Let the people do what the people are. And I kept thinking, I know one of our interviews said this and it occurred to me while you were talking, it's Yuli Chedapali, punish the machine. And that's exactly what it is. You know, he said, just let the computers do what it is. Don't distrust the data. Nobody's taking your job. Nobody's taking your role. We're trying to make it easier for you and give you better decisions so you can practice at the highest level. It was really such a noble mission. And I think that came across really, really well in the interview because he focused so much on why this matters and how it's important and how it can truly impact people.
So well said. Thank you.
And thank you all for watching. Stay tuned for the interview with Pramod on Thursday. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.